Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back with another part of the chopping clinic. I wanted to show you this tool, which obviously I don't know much about other than, you know, the fact that I keep it here to help me eyeball certain things and make sure that things are squared up and all of that. I think this is called a divider. I could be wrong. It's one of these fancy measuring tools, and I've had mine for a while. But I wanted to show you how, you know, if you don't really, if the job is more complex and you don't want to just eyeball it, then you can come in and start taking some measurements, you know, and you see that sometimes you have to, you know, finagle it a little bit just to get it right, okay? And again, it's not a big deal because, you know, later on you can sand things and after all, it's styrene. I mean, it's pretty forgiving, but you know you want to be as exact as possible. So that's pretty darn close, you know. And you also could, in fact, utilize some of the tools, you know, as you get to learn them, know them a little bit, you realize that you could move some of the tape with the back edge of your tool there, and then get your, you know, your better, there you go, that's pretty darn close. And now, one of the things that I wanted to tell you is that, you know, if you can't have access to one of these, there are other cheaper models, but if you don't, then use a compass. It would work just the same way. Okay, one of those cheapy school ones. Or if not, then you eyeball it. Now, one of the things that I was going to tell you in terms of prioritizing the number of cuts and what, you know, and what's going to happen first, you have to remember that the weakest part of this cab are these pillars here, and so once you cut them, they, you know, you could risk breaking them or bending them, so you have to, you know, work slow, take your time, and as I said, once you start cutting, you know, just make sure that you go slow and you go making your groove cuts, you know. I go a little bit at a time, and as I said, it'll take maybe 30 minutes, maybe 40 minutes, maybe an hour, heck, maybe even 2 hours, but just go slow and make sure you stay on the edge of that tape. Don't jump it, because then you're gonna mar the tape, and this is why I go around it a few times. And as I said, this tape is cheap. So next time you see this, it's going to already be cut. And then from there, we're going to work on this half first. And I'm going to come back in and cut this out. Then I am going to cut out this part of the door, okay? Because we're going to need that. And then go from there. So as I said, slow, but keep a steady, even pace, and you will not mess up. And when you make the cut, this is just going to pancake down, and you know, of course, you're going to have a little bit of welding to do. But that's what's going to give this rat rod some character. All right. So the blues rat is well on its way, and so stay tuned in for more Cranky Show, my friends. All right, everybody. Dr. Cranky back with another extension of the clinic. I want to show you a little bit of the actual cutting, in part because I know one of you is going to say, "Oh, but you didn't show us how you are cutting." All right. Now, one of the things that you need to keep in mind is that you, as I said earlier, you want a very fine-toothed blade. This is, I think they sell this at the local hobby shop. I just love it because it's small enough and handy enough so that you can make your cuts. Now, I've already made this cut, and I'm very pleased with it. It took me, you could see it there. It took me about 10, 15 minutes to go slow. Normally, I would suggest make the cuts at the delicate place first, like, you know, because there, as I said, you know, this part, these A pillars are really delicate, and so you want to stay straight, okay? And you want to go slow. Don't put too much pressure on it, okay? And do this every once in a while. See, your blade gets stuck, so remove it and clean the edges, and the same thing. Get some of that styrene, the little slivers and curlicues, okay? And again, just make sure that you're cutting slowly, without pressure, and very slow, especially in these parts that are really, really delicate, okay? And don't worry about it. Eventually, it's gonna go through. Of course, you can turn it over and check to see where you're at, but every time you remove the blade, take the opportunity, or you could keep a little brush and just remove the excess you're cutting off. And again, go back into the groove and keep cutting. And you want to go slow without putting any pressure, because you also don't want to cut yourself. If you put a lot of pressure, you're going to mar the plastic, possibly break it, and probably puncture your finger. So again, slow and methodic wins the day, okay? That's how you do it. Otherwise, you're going to mangle it and you're going to ruin it. So just, you know, go slow. And, you know, every once in a while, you could turn it at an angle, not the blade, but the cab, and just continue to cut, okay? And continue to stay straight against that tape edge. I told you, we do about 3 or 4 turns. See, there you go. It's cut. So this side... Now, if I lift it, you see it. See, this side is completely cut, okay? So now we're going to go to this side and repeat the process, all right? And I've already got the groove on this one. So you're going to see it. You're going to see the thing come off. So work slow. I cannot repeat that enough times. Work slow, work steady, and work methodically, and you will. There's no hurry for doing this, because you want to do it right. Then we're going to show you a couple of other tips and tricks for getting everything squared up, all right? And the beauty of this is that we're not working with metal, we're working with styrene, which is absolutely wonderful for squaring things up and for getting the parts to come together and get glued back on nicely. All right, stay tuned in for more.